Hi student, good morning to all, and this is a video for class 12 informatics practices. And in this video now we are going to discuss about the data visualization. So what is data visualization? For example, now I want to show something to the audience. So in that audience, everything I'm showing in the text, the audience gets some bored. Okay, so the same thing if I'm going to show with that graphical format, that means in the picture form, it means the audience gets some interest to see this object, correct? So same like that, if you want to show anything to the audience, it is the graphical format, means it is easily they can understand. That's why we are telling that a picture is worth your thousands of words. Correct. So what is the data visualization means? The data visualization is the technique to present the data in the pictorial or graphical format. What we are giving to the user, that output is in the picture format. So when we are giving in the graphical format, it is used to take the decision makers to analyze the data in visually, and then we can get the result easily. Okay, that's why I'm telling them the data visualization is very helpful format for the in Python concern. And the data in the graphical format allows them to identify the new trends and then pattern easily. How it is possible? Okay, now I tell this one example. For example, we are the sales manager in leading global organization. The organization plans to study the sales detail of each product across the region and countries, and this is to identify the product which has the highest sales in a particular region end of the productions. And this research will enable the organization to increase the manufacturing of that product in the particular region. The data involved in this research might be huge and complex. The research on this large numeric data is difficult and time consuming when it's performed manually. Correct? So when the numerical data is plotted on the graph for converted to chart, it is easy to identify the patterns and we can get the result accurately. Correct? So the main benefit of the data visualizations are as follows. And it is a main benefit, it is a multi-platform data visualization tool built in on the NumPy and Sybase frameworks. Therefore, it is a fast and efficient. So if you are using the Matplotlib, and it will be working in the very fast and efficient. And then we can get the many operation system with the graphic backends. And then this is a process for the high quality graphs, graphics and the plots to print and view the range of graphics format. And large communicate support will be using in this pyplot method, and it has the full control over graphs or plot styles such as the line property and thirds, and then assess property will be there. And then some more benefits, it simplifies the complex quantity information, it helps to analyze and explore the big data easily, and it identifies the areas that need attention to improvement, and it identifies the relationship between the data points and the variable, and it explores the new patterns and reveals the hidden pattern in the data. And then with the help of the data visualization, we can get the answer clearly and accuracy, and then with the efficiency we can see the result in pyplot. Correct. And then the purpose of the data visualization and showing the better analyze, and then we can get the quick answer, and then identifying the pattern easily, and then finding the error, and then understanding the story concept easily, and exploring the business insight, and the crossing the latest trends, because everything we are showing in the pictures, and then we can analyze the data easily. Everything will be in the chart method, correct? So which is the highest and which is the lowest, we can identify the data easily. And now we are seeing all the charts in the TV show now, and then in the news today, what is the, what about the corona status, and then compared than the yesterday, today passion high, or else compared than the yesterday it will be low, and then the comparison, we can see that comparison easily, correct? That's why the showing the result in the chart method. So the data visualization is used to, we can identify the result easily. That's why we are using this data visualization. And then plotting library. So how we can use this in the data visualization? We import this one library. The library name is called as Matplotlib library. And this is a whole Python package library used to create the 2D graphs and the plots by using the Python script. And PyPlot is a model in Matplotlib library, and which is support is very wide variety of graphics and plots, namely histogram, bar graphs, power and then error chart, etc. It is used to along with the NumPy to provide an environment for the MATLAB. So that means with the help of we have to import that library. The library name is called as Matplotlib library, and then in this library the whole model will be there. And what is the model name is means PyPlot, and in that PyPlot what are the data we can use, and the particular library we taken from the Matplotlib library. And what is PyPlot means, it is provided for the state machines interface to the plotting library in the Matplotlib. It means that figures and axes are implicitly and automatically created to the achieve the desired plot. So what kind of plot the user want need, then the particular data we can use this, okay? And then next concept, Matplotlib library, and then features, and then the following features are provided from the Matplotlib library for the data visualizations: drawing, customization and saving. And then drawing means the plots can be drawn based on the past data through the specific function. Based on the functions the user can draw that, because number of chart will be available, bar chart, pie chart, and then this kind of chart will be there. The user, based on this user requirements, we can take it then. And the next customization, plots can be customized as per the requirements. So what is the user requirements, based on this we can satisfy that and specify in the arguments of the functions, like colors, what is the color we need that, what is the style we need that, and what is the width we need that, how we can add the labels and the title of the chart and the legend plots. Everything we can easily customize it with the help of data visualizations. And then after complete our work, we can save this document, and this facility is also available under there. And then how to plot in the Matplotlib library. First we should install the Matplotlib library in your Python program. So how we are going to install the Matplotlib library means, first you should open the command prompt. After opening the command prompt, and then we should find out the path where it will be stored in the pip in the program. And then normally we will be there in the pip in that system32 only. So we should find out that. So install pip install matplotlib like this command in that command window. So after that, py import the matplotlib library using this import matplotlib.pyplot as plt statement. So if you are giving this statement, now it not showing the any error means, and then now it's not showing any error means the program will be correct now, okay? And then next, to set the data points and plot of methods of plt object. And then numpy we are using the which object, we are using that np. And then here we are matching using that plt object we are using that. And call of the show method, we can display the plot, and then save the plot or graphs is if you require. If you want to need this, you can save the plot. And then so types of plot we are using that line plot, bar graph, histogram, pie chart, and the frequency polygon, and the fox plot and scatter plot we are using in that program. And the next class I show you how to create a program, and the remaining thing we will see in the next class. And thank you, dear.